Let's set up PostgreSQL with persistent data, just like we do in production environment.
First, we will install the Docker. Go to docker.com, and right on your home page, you will see a big button saying download Docker desktop, along with the operating system for which you are installing it. That in my case is Windows 10. Just click on it and it will start the download. To save the time, I have already downloaded the file. And here it is. Next, we have to install it. For that, right click on it and select Run as Administrator. This will bring up the installer. On the first screen, you have two checkboxes. Make sure both are checked, then press OK. This will install the Docker on your desktop. That's it. That's all you have to do. I will fast forward this installation a little bit to save your time. Installation successful. Press close and you are done. Now come to your desktop and double click on Docker's icon. Accept the license agreement. Now it will take a few seconds to start the Docker engine. That's it, engine is running. Now close it. Now go visit hub.docker.com. Here you have to create an account. Go ahead and do so. Since I already have an account, so I will just sign in. Once you are done, then come to the search bar and search Postgres. And open up this first image that says Docker official image in front of it. From this page, we will only need two commands. First, this Docker pull command to pull the Postgres image. And second, this Docker run command to create a Postgres container. We will modify this run command a little bit as per the production norms. So let's move on and set up the Postgres. Now that we have installed the Docker, next we will set up Postgres on it. Let's do that. Step 1. Pull the image. Open up your command prompt or shell if you have installed the Docker on your Linux or Mac and write. Docker pull Postgres. This command will pull the latest image of the Postgres from the hub. Done. Now we have the image. Next, we have to create a container using this image. So let's do that. Step 2. Create the container. To create the container, we have to execute the Docker run command. Before doing that, let me explain to you the command. Command starts with the reserved phrase Docker run. And then using --name option, we give a name to our container. In my case, this name is Postgres_img. You can name your container whatever you want. Followed by the name, we have -d option. This option will run the container in background and print its ID once it's done. Next, we have -e option. Using this option, we are setting the environment variable Postgres_password, using which I am setting the password, which in my case is Postgres. You can set whatever password you want. Next, we are exposing port using -p option. Here we are mapping the port 5432 of the container against the port 5432 of the Docker machine. This option is important if you want to connect with this Postgres database using client like pgadmin, VS Code or dbeaver that are installed on your operating system. Don't worry, as in the upcoming videos, I will show you how to connect with the Postgres. and then comes dash V option. Using this option, I'm mapping a directory that I have created in my D drive with the name Postgres against the directory data, whose path is this. So what's happening here is that all the data of the database will be saved inside the data directory. This is the virtual file system created inside the Docker container. Therefore, this data is not persistent. As soon as the container stops or restarts, this data will be lost. To make this data persistent or permanent, we are mapping this virtual directory to a physical directory that is created on the host machine. This host machine, in my case, is my Windows 10 operating system. After mapping, whatever data that is going to be saved inside this data directory will also get copied in the directory d/postgres which I created on my host machine. That way, the data will always stay there no matter what happens to the container. Anyways, in the end, we have the name of the image using which we are creating this container. I will leave this command in the description. You can copy it from there. On successful execution, we will have our Postgres installed and set up on the Docker with persistent data. Let's do that. We are all set to execute the Docker run command, but before that, make sure that your Docker engine is up and running. Mine is running. So let's minimize it. And here we are again on the command prompt. Now let's execute the Docker run command. This is the same command that I just showed you. Let's execute it. Done. We have successfully installed Postgres on Docker. If you want to check, then go back to your Docker desktop. And there you can see your image. In my case, it's Postgres_img.
So that is how we install PostgreSQL on Docker for production. In the next video, we will learn how to connect with PostgreSQL using tools like command prompt and VS Code. Hope you like this video. If so, then give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel, because in the next video, we will learn how to connect with PostgreSQL using PSQL on Docker. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.